It's 8 a.m. in the morning, and you've practically stayed up all night revising for your midterms. Today's test is on geography, and it really isn't one of your stronger subjects, hence the all-nighter. You are seated, and you're feeling confident, maybe a little tired, but definitely confident. And then the papers are handed out, the teacher pulls off the good old joke saying she knows the first question of the paper. The class is like, alright, what is it? And then she says it's the name and class. Bruh. Then you're allowed to answer and you're feeling good. The questions you revised are there, you're feeling yourself. You're doing so good that you're looking up at the class, seeing others so focused, and you're like, damn, couldn't be me. This is a piece of cake. And then you flip to page 7. And there it is, a diagram of some wet soil and downflow of water, asking you about what this process is called. Wait, hold on, I know the answer, I literally read it last night. And in fact, you did, it's calcification. But in the moment, you can't seem to place your finger on what the word is. You can almost picture it in your brain, hell, you can even remember the chapter that had this info, but you just can't seem to know the word. You've continued with the rest of the paper and came back to the question, and finally, you've given up, and you hit it with a good ol'. Damn! If only you could remember everything you ever read, life would be so much easier. Exams would be an easy A. You'd never forget your best friend's birthday, and you'd never miss on a deadline. I mean, you'd always have the best comebacks during arguments instead of coming up with one later in your room. If only I never forgot anything. If I were given 3 wishes, firstly, more wishes, like, come on, bruh, obviously. And then I'm wishing my brain couldn't forget anything. Like, that could only be good for me, right? To that, I've got one thing to say.
You done messed up, A.A. Ron!
Because as studies have shown, forgetting things might not be a game-breaking bug, but more like a game-saving patch. In other words, we may have evolved the ability to forget intentionally. Wait, what? Why would I want to forget intentionally? Well,
let me tell you something!
Alexandra Wolf is a 22-year-old woman that lives with her mother in Southern Maryland, and there is something special about her. She is one of the 55 people in the US that have the condition many may know as highly superior autobiographical memory, or HSAM, or, well, someone who is unable to forget anything. Let me ask you a question. Think of 2017. What can you recall? Maybe a handful of memories? But I'm sure the day by day is probably a blur. But Alexandra, on the other hand, would remember an inconsequential trip to Walmart in 2017 and everything she probably bought that day. She wouldn't just remember it, it would be an almost physical experience for her. She sees what she saw that day, hears what she heard, and emotionally feels what she felt, right down to getting sick to her stomach or getting a headache. There are 2 major ways a disorder like this would affect a person. Spoilers alert, both bad. Let me explain. The 8th of July in 2004 was a day spent by her in a bathing suit by a pool, laughing and playing with her 10-year-old cousin. They ate mac and cheese and swam and generally had lots of fun. Now, let's go back to the present, where she admits that she replays that day in her head about 4 times a week. And over the past couple of years, she estimates to have probably spent around 2,000 hours reliving that one day. For many of us, even without this disorder, we spent some time reminiscing the good old days to keep us going in the midst of sad times. Now imagine if you can relive it just as it was. I bet that a lot of us would never get out of bed because we'd be busy getting high off the ecstasy of the past. Whew. So that's the first problem with not being able to forget. Okay, alright, so what's the other way that this would affect a person? This is probably more obvious, but PTSD. Yeah, post-traumatic stress disorder. It's an event that develops in those that have experienced a very shocking, scary, or dangerous event. The person would often relive the traumatic event through vivid flashbacks and nightmares, and may even experience feelings of isolation, irritability, and guilt. Some even develop insomnia and trouble concentrating on things. I think you already got the point. But imagine, right? Every single embarrassing or sad or scary moment being vividly etched into your brain. It would be impossible to escape your past. For Alexandra, who was bullied by a boy years ago, she thinks of the moment again and again, which will inevitably knock some of her confidence down. She says she often feels frustrated with her preoccupation with the past, and that in her life, there are no fresh days, no clean slates without association. Every morning she wakes up, details of some day years ago are scrolling through her mind, profoundly affecting the new day she's in. These are the reasons why James McGaugh, the neurobiologist from the University of California that documented the first case of HSAM, says that forgetting might be adaptive. The thing is, the problems only pile up from here. Bill Brown, another man with this disorder, has kept in touch with others that are in this same situation, and he said, practically everyone with HSAM has or is struggling with depression. Very few of them have been able to maintain a long-term marriage, including Brown himself, with the rumor being only 2 out of 55, and this is because the difference in his memory has led to misunderstandings in his relationship. You see, people with HSAM just fundamentally think differently. They'd be able to remember everything their partner ever did, and just because he can remember something that his partner did wrong doesn't mean he's still holding it against them. The sad thing is, it's taken Brown a long time to realize that people without his ability probably don't understand that distinction, because after all, if you're bringing it up, the logic would be that, you're probably still holding it against me. So, he says, while he has learned how to manage the memories and not to focus on the bad stuff, he still thinks it might be nice to sometimes forget. Well, yeah, maybe forgetting things every now and then isn't all that bad. We tend to only notice when our brain fumbles and forgets the wrong thing, instead of all the times it clutched up for us and reminded us instead. Thinking about it, it's kind of like how people online mostly tend to respond to hate messages or comments instead of the positive ones. But to be fair, that's just how we are. We are psychologically built to have a negativity bias, and this is linked to something we call loss aversion, a cognitive bias that describes why the pain of losing is psychologically twice as powerful as the pleasure of gaining. Look, at the end of the day, all I'm trying to say is, the next time you forget something important and you're cussing yourself out for being so dumb, relax. Your brain is just looking out for you. You know, it's just trying to help you out. And yeah, it messed up and forgot the wrong thing, but we're human. We make mistakes, and that's what makes us us. So cut yourself some slack. Your body and brain are constantly looking out for you. Even when you don't care, your body does. So, come on. Show it some love. After all, you only have one. Thanks for watching.